Hello, my name is Chris Sparrow with Cirris It, and today we're here to do a demo of the new 8100 low voltage tester and an overview of its specifications. The 8100 is a low voltage cable harness tester that comes in a base unit of 256 test points and is expandable to 100,000 test points in 256 test point increments. It has the ability to test for shorts, opens, miswires, and connection resistance depending on your tester specification. And also that's new with the 8100 is the ability to do custom instructions. The front of the tester has 64 headers that you would connect your interface cables, as well as bumpers for the ejector latches and a front probe port. On the back of the 8100, you have your inputs and outputs for your expansion capabilities. It is a 16-pin ribbon style cable that is connection between your test boxes, a QR code that allows you to scan using your favorite scanning app. It'll redirect you to a website that allow you to download user manuals, getting started guides, as well as our EasyWire software to get you started. You also have your grounding point and your USB power interface that also connects to your laptop that is running EasyWire that control the tester. Of note, the 8100 tester does not require an external power supply. It is actually powered by the USB port itself. If needed, you can expand your 8100 tester to more test points by using expansion boxes. You simply would use an expansion cable, plugging into the out portion of the base unit and plugging in to the in portion of the expansion module. To connect your 8100 to a PC, simply take the supplied USB cable and plug one end to the base unit of the USB tester and the other end to the USB port of your PC. The 8100 has the ability to test complex harness assemblies. For today, we will use a simple demo board to help demonstrate the 8100's capabilities. We will be testing this cable with our 8100 tester that will be interfacing with the demo board. To do that, we will use a ribbon cable to interface to the transition board to the front of the 8100 tester. Our demo board will have a mating military circuit connector, an ECC spring probe block, and two easy hooks to help us test our cable. The 8100 is controlled by our EasyWire software. EasyWire is our premium software that gives you granular control over your testing capabilities. When launching EasyWire on your PC, you'll be given a login screen. You can change different users that give you different login access, but for now, we will just use the master login. When EasyWire loads, your main screen will house all your test programs. You'll be faced with different buttons. A few of them to highlight is your edit, verify, and test buttons, as well as the help button over here on the bottom right. The help button in EasyWire gives you access to frequently asked questions and troubleshooting articles. To help us create a test program using the 8100, we will click the Create Test Program button, and you'll be presented with two different choices: learn with EasyWire adapters or smart adapters, or learn create using traditional fixturing. Because we're not using smart lights, we will use learn create using traditional fixturing. For this demonstration, we have already set up a test program. To review it, we will highlight the test program and click the edit button to open the test program editor. You'll be presented with six tabs. We will want to work through each tab individually to help us set up our test program. This first tab, Define Connectors, is where we will list or assign the different mating connectors that we'll be using within our program. Here you will see that we have assigned the different connectors from the connector library. Tab 2 is where we will be able to assign the system test points to the connectors If we are using smart lights, we can also assign them here. Tab 3, Set Test Defaults. This is where we can go through and set our test program defaults. We have the ability to set our low voltage connection resistance and our installation resistance settings. We can also change to a different test method if desired. Here we can also set our operator notes, operator inputs, and configure our test reports. For more information on these, there are resources in the description. Tab 4, Define Instructions. Here we will have the ability to add different instructions for what the tester will be looking for. You have two options to create your test programs within EasyWire. You can allow the 8100 to automatically learn the test instructions, or you can manually enter the instructions using the different instruction options at the bottom. Tab 5, View Nets. Here you'll be able to see all the different nets that you've created using the instruction on from Tab 4. Tab 6, Label Points. Here you can change the name of your points to match your documentation. Once your test program is created, you'll be ready to test. To start the test, click the Start button. And if the test passes, you'll be presented with a good screen. You can see that this was accomplished fairly quickly. Now to test a fault or a bad cable, let's introduce an error. I'm going to disconnect one of the pins to create an open. Here you will see we have a bad cable and we have a wire missing between test point J2-3 and J1-J. If the operator can identify and fix the bad wire, you can hit retest and the test will pass. With the wrist strap and your test program in a build mode, simply grab a loose wire and EasyWire will identify what cavity that loose wire should be populated to. This has been a Cirris 8100 demo. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us using the information in the description.